Welcome. I'm Dr. Nancy Morioka Douglas. I am a clinical professor and family doctor at Stanford Family Medicine. Today, we're going to demonstrate the techniques of behavioral activation, a very powerful way to help elderly patients who are having problems with depression. So, Mrs. Smith, it's so good to see you again. You know,
thank you.
We've seen each other a few times now, and today I've just noticed that you don't seem quite yourself.
I'm really not feeling pretty down these days.
Yeah, I was noticing that for that PHQ-9 questionnaire that we had you complete, mm-hmm. you did mark that you were feeling low, that you were having trouble with your sleep.
Right. Trouble with my sleep and trouble getting myself active during the day, just feeling like there's nothing much to do that's of any value, so I've been feeling pretty down.
And has that affected what you're doing in your daily life at all?
Yes, I can go for hours without doing anything that I consider to be pleasurable. I just hang around the house and look at all the stuff that maybe I should do, and I can't get the energy to do it. It's just really a bummer.
So, you know, I hear that a lot from people. Mm. I think it actually is a pretty common thing, maybe part of the human condition. Mm. And I don't know if you've noticed this, but what happens when you start getting into that way of feeling, it kind of spirals downward. Mm-hmm. Have you noticed that?
You mean if I have a bad day and I don't do anything, then the next day might be even worse, and I have even less energy to do something?
Maybe not the next day it would get so bad so quickly, but I do think that if you look at this diagram for the cycle of depression, if you have stressors that can create behaviors.
Oh boy, I've had some of those stressors. I sure have. Yeah.
They can cause some emotions of depression and sadness.
Mm-hmm.
They can generate thoughts of not wanting to do anything.
Oh boy, is that ever me? Yeah.
So one of the things that's pretty powerful is that just like this can be a downward spiral, mm-hmm. we can also reverse it and make it an upward spiral and get you to not feel quite as sad. So it's very difficult to change emotions.
Uh-huh.
I think thoughts are equally difficult to try to block out negative thoughts.
Mm-hmm.
And stressors, well, we don't have much power over stress.
Sure don't.
But behaviors are something that each of us has control over. And if you can change your behavior, you can bring yourself up out of that spiral.
How would I do that, though? I have so much trouble just getting myself going in the day.
So there is a technique that will help called behavioral activation.
Mm-hmm.
And they've done a lot of research on it for people that are older and depressed. And it turns out that it is as effective and sometimes more effective than medication.
Really? Well,
yeah.
I wasn't looking forward to taking meds, but if you have other ideas, I'll listen to them.
So the thing about behavioral activation is we're going to work together to come up with four activities that
mm-hmm.
give you pleasure, that help lift your mood,
mm-hmm.
and you're going to figure out what you want to do, when you want to do it, and then we're going to see how it goes.
Wow, that sounds pretty hard to do.
Well, we're going to take really small little baby steps.
Like
to
what? What would be something I could do?
Think about something that in the past has made you feel happy or has helped to lighten your mood.
Well, I used to enjoy talking to my friend Ellen. That did lighten my mood because she always had something funny to say.
That sounds like a really good behavior. Let me write it down.
Okay.
And so I'll write down, talk to Ellen. All right. So that's exactly the kind of small thing
mm-hmm.
that might help lift your mood. Can you think of something else that gives you pleasure?
Well, I like to read the newspaper. Sometimes, though, I lose my ability to concentrate, and so I get discouraged with myself and I throw the newspaper away. But maybe if I just tried to read the front page and didn't try to read the whole thing, that might be doable.
That's a really great idea. Mm. So I'll write down, read the front page of the newspaper.
Okay.
What else has given you pleasure before?
Well, I used to love to listen to music, but, you know, I don't have a CD player. I don't have a really good computer to listen to music through, and my iPod is broken. So I'm trying to think if there's some way I could listen to music another way.
What kind of music do you like to listen to?
Oh, I like classical music very much. There used to be a classical music station. I could try to find out if that classical music station still exists.
I think it does. I know that I've heard it on FM radio. I'm not sure the AM version is still there, but that is definitely something that I think still exists.
You think so?
Yep.
Because then I would borrow a radio from somebody in the house, put it on in my room, and listen to music on that station for a little while until I stopped being interested in the music. But I could give that a try.
That sounds like a really good idea. So listen to classical music. Well, you're already up to three.
Oh, wow.
And they say that four a day keeps the blues away. Mm-hmm. So four activities a day keeps the blues away. What one more small thing might you do?
Okay. Well, looking at flowers in my neighbor's yard, that gives me pleasure.
How lovely. So looking at flowers. Mm-hmm. So let me just recapitulate for you. Talking to Ellen, reading the front page of the newspaper, listening to classical music on the radio, and looking at flowers. So what kind of barriers might you encounter that would make it difficult to do those?
Well, with Ellen, what might happen is she travels so much, I wouldn't get her. So that would be a barrier, because then I'd be so disappointed I didn't reach her after I tried to do it. I guess I could substitute another friend.
That sounds like a great backup method.
Okay, so I would say maybe call one friend. That could be, instead of Ellen, I could say call one friend.
That sounds great. Are there any other obstacles, reading the newspaper, listening to music, looking at flowers?
Well, the music is a problem, so I would have to solve that with my family. But I think I could do it. I think they would try to help me. The flowers part means I'd have to get dressed and go out, unless I put on a nice bathrobe and just shuffled over there. That could be okay.
I think that sounds like a fine idea.
Okay.
So the next step, and this is your homework for the week. It's a way that we can be sure that we're on the same page. So you have your four goals, and then we're going to try to figure out how often during the week.
Okay.
So talking to a friend, how often in the week might that work for you?
Oh, maybe as many as four times in a week. I could try talking to a friend.
Great.
I could do that.
And reading the paper?
Oh, I could do that, I think, maybe 5 days a week or six even.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Uh-huh.
Listening to the music?
That's the hard one, but I try to maybe three times a week or four times a week.
And looking at beautiful flowers.
Well, that I could try maybe, I could start out with maybe three times a week to get over there. I could try.
That sounds like a great plan.
Okay.
So talking to a friend four times a week, reading the front page of the newspaper five times a week, listening to music three times a week, and looking at flowers three times a week. You know, this is exactly what research has proven will help lift your mood, help you get out of that hole of depression and wanting to stay inside. So what we'll do is, talk is cheap, I found, and I really like to help people do what they hope to do. In a week, either I or my practice coordinator, Daisy, will be calling to see how it went. And then we'll make a plan for the coming week. How does that sound?
Oh, it sounds okay. I just hope I can measure up. I don't want to disappoint you, and I don't want to disappoint myself. What if I can't do all those things?
That'll just help us understand what to plan for the next week. You know, it's really difficult with these first set of plans to scale it right. It's hard to know what's possible and what's not. But let's just give it a try. The evidence proves it's very powerful. I think it's worth taking a shot at it, and we'll try to figure out what the next week will look like based on your experiences this coming week. How does that sound?
I'll give it a try, Doctor.
Sounds good.
Okay, thank you.